show has been sponsored by Plainview Farm, Hubbardston, Massachusetts. Their alpacas and llamas love to have company, so contact them to book a special visit for your mom's group, scout outing, field trip, or fundraiser. And Bill and Patrick Shea, Hubbardston, Massachusetts, owners of the world's largest collection of Back to the Future memorabilia. They offer VIP tours by appointment. You can contact them directly. All of the profits from donations go to the Michael J. Fox Foundation for Parkinson's Research. Who knew that a little town in north central Massachusetts with a population of a little over 4,000 would hold such hidden gems? But that's why we do what we do. Our next stop was Plainview Farm to meet the alpacas and llamas.
So our boys are over on this side, our girls are on this side.
Oh, you keep them separated?
Did you take freshman health class? Give you that. Yes, and give it a little shake.
Are we down here?
You will be.
Come down here. Here we go. Oh my gosh! Oh my gosh! Oh my gosh!
Wait. I can't do it.
And give me your other hand. They don't have teeth in the top, so they can't bite you.
Okay.
Oh, Hyacinth's coming to say. Hyacinth's our one-eyed llama, so you have to make sure you're on her.
Where is she?
She's the one who just walked away.
Oh, that's...
Let me try to get her. So. Hyacinth, baby.
Yeah, she's our new girl.
All right, you want to feed some?
I'll get you some. Granny.
Oh my gosh, that was gone in no time. They're like, okay, you don't have any more, I'm going away.
Tiffany, girl.
Here. Here. Oh,
look at that.
You sweet girls.
Wow.
So we're going to test you later. Okay, this is Mika, this is Abby, Summer, her mother, Emmeline, Tiffany, Nutmeg, Belle.
How can you keep them straight?
No different than a school teacher. they all have their certain little, this one's brown, that one's black.
Is that fence supposed to be open?
Yeah, it's okay.
Okay, the boys can't.
We have three llamas and all the rest are alpacas, 32 alpacas.
She's a llama.
So yeah. Two ways to tell, number one is size. Mm-hmm. Llamas are much bigger. And also you see banana shaped ears. So she's looking at you over there. You can see her banana shaped ears.
Why is she staying away from everybody?
She is.
She's the protector.
Yeah, she's the guardian. Not guard llama. Guard llama, picture junkyard dog. You don't cross that line.
Okay.
But she's guardian. She is protective of the herd.
Okay.
But she doesn't necessarily want to be touched and handled. Whereas Hyacinth up there is a little bit of a loner. She's not quite part of the herd, but she's very happy going back up to the barn and eating hay.
Okay.
Then Julia, the white llama over here, she's the cheerleader. She's the, you have food, I'm your best friend. all different personalities. Just like people, there's some you'd go out to dinner with, some you wouldn't. There's the ones that like to be handled more, or put up with it better, and the ones that it's not in their personality, so we don't try to bother them,
Tell me how they got here. How did these animals come to be here?
We get them at the alpaca store. My story is first llama I've met kissed me.
Aww.
There used to be a guy in southern Vermont many years ago that used to have a llama bazaar Memorial Day weekend.
Uh-huh.
And he used to get 10,000 people on Memorial Day weekend on the side of a mountain on a dirt road to look at llamas and alpacas. And I got kissed. And so my kids grew up with dad saying he's going to be a llama farmer someday. And fast forward, llamas became too big. Uh-huh. And alpacas became more the right size. They had a alpaca show at the DCU Center, happened to be on the email list. Uh-huh. And I was, honey, let's go. I closed the place 2 days. We moved here that spring and that fall. One of my favorite jokes to do at the Spencer Fair was to walk up to the alpaca tent and take my credit card out. Well, that particular year, my granddaughter grabbed the card, went and gave it to Debbie, and Debbie said, or the guy, my granddaughter, said that, you know, Debbie took away Grampy's credit card, so he won't buy alpacas from you. And so we had our first four 30 days later, and that was, that'll be 12 years in October. And
wow.
Then I do my own shearing. I shear for other people locally.
Okay. So you sell them?
And, yep. We utilize all the fleece in some form or another. And,
okay.
And we do get some fleece from the people we shear to that don't use it at all.
Okay.
So I shear about 150 animals a year, locally here.
How many times a year do you?
Once a year.
Once a year?
Take the winter coat off in the spring.
Okay.
And then some of the fiber, you know, people buy, you know, use it for their own crafts. They buy the raw fiber.
Mm-hmm.
Yarn is made at a mill in Vermont. So all
okay.
the natural colored yarn we have is from our animals. Then there's a company in Fall River we send our fiber down to. They get fiber from throughout the U.S. They do the manufacturing. We buy back socks, hats, mittens, gloves.
Oh.
And then we also buy from importers in
uh-huh.
Peru and so on.
Okay.
And but yeah, it yeah, they're pretty special. Are you my special girl? Say, I really don't want to be right now.
Like,
I don't want to be. Say, I was busy. I was busy. Hi.
Oh, now she's coming.
Hi. Who's my pretty girl? There we go, huh? Who's my good girl, huh? Kiss, 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 kiss. Yeah. Yep. This is the good spot right here. This is where she likes to be. You can come get a hug too. I'll let you.
Oh, you let me. I don't want to frighten her away. Hi, baby.
Give hugs. Kisses.
Oh no, you don't. Yeah, my
ears are going down.
No, not like horses. Their ears go back and forth.
Oh, okay.
More have to read the situation versus the ear position. I mean, it can be that there's, you know, getting ready. It's funny, you'll hear the occasional stomach gurgle or the, you know, upper stomach
uh-huh.
gurgle, getting ready to, you know, spit if they so desired. Or, in general, when they spit, it's usually at each other. It's usually over food. Or like your petting zoo, llamas and alpacas have been taught bad habits. They've been taught you're going to be mean to them, so we're going to spit first and ask questions later. So in general, this is more along the lines of what you get. Huh, pretty girl? Yeah. Get that bug bite. Must be a bug bite right there. Huh.
That is so nice.
You're a good girl. Yes, you are.
I needed to hire somebody. I've been able to find somebody.
Oh!
I have three.
Hyacinth. Hyacinth. Hello, girl. Hello. Hi.
Hi. Here's my special girl.
Hi! Hi! Oh, look at you! Oh! Oh, wow!
Oh my goodness!
Look at that! Those look, and they're.
And it's from her.
Giacomo's.
You'd be surprised how many hidden secrets are on these back roads, like things you never know existed.
Mm-hmm.
And you'll see some of them, but there's more hidden gems. Like, they. Yeah,
oh.
You have no idea, like the craziness that will be hiding on the back roads of a small town.
Mm-hmm. I'd like to know.
Yeah.
Can we share the secret?
You can follow him. He'll show you a right. bunch of them. There's not enough time in the day to hit them all. I'll tell you this much.
Okay.
The only thing I have is this vintage that works.
Is your body?
No, I'm not.
You've got to call.
Yeah. Who are you going to call?
Who are you going to call?
Who are you going to call?
Two grannies.